I'm doing my honors thesis, a George H. Cook honors thesis. We're researching pancreatic cancer, which is a very deadly cancer in the United States and around the world because it's very hard to detect it early on. We have been researching the protein osteopontin for many, many years now before I was even there. And osteopontin is a protein that's found in all body fluids, and it has many various functions throughout the body. Osteopontin has been correlated with cancer progression of various cancers, including pancreatic cancer. Smoking of nicotine products, of tobacco products, has also been found to correlate with progression of various cancers, such as lung cancer and pancreatic cancer. So the studies that I'm conducting are linking nicotine with osteopontin and how those together work to make pancreatic cancer as lethal as it is, or the prognosis for it worse. One of the ways in which we're studying the effects of OPN on pancreatic cancer is we have pancreatic cancer cell lines that we work with. For example, if we want to see if these cells make more osteopontin, are they going to be more cancerous? So what we do is something called transfection. We insert pieces of DNA of that code for osteopontin into these cells. It's a lengthy process and a lot of trial and error is involved, but the goal is to get these cells to secrete more osteopontin. Another thing we do is we try to suppress the osteopontin in these cells in order to see whether if these cells make less osteopontin, is that going to make them less cancerous. Many studies have been conducted that have studied the links of osteopontin to cancer. Specifically, cancers can be made worse by metastasizing, and that is spreading around the body. Cancer cells migrate throughout the body and create new tumors, which make it a lot worse. And osteopontin has been linked to those activities of cancer cells, to the migration, to proliferation. It's actually, I think it's been used as a marker. So if there's high osteopontin in the blood, in the plasma, then that correlates with a worse prognosis for cancer, more likelihood of the cancer metastasizing and spreading. Studies have been conducted in animals, transgenic mice, for example, which naturally have been made to not make osteopontin, and their cancers have not been as bad. My faculty advisor is Dr. David Denhardt from the Cell Biology Department. Dr. Denhardt is a really great research advisor, and he is very knowledgeable. He's always there, unlike a lot of other research advisors, so he's available. And after a couple of years of working there, he's come to trust me enough to allow me to say what direction I want to go in, to be able to tell him what I think about certain projects, and he values my opinion, I think. For the past several years that I've been doing research, I've learned just how a lab's goals evolve, how, in general, research is conducted, how you have to collaborate with others, how you have to troubleshoot techniques, how, just in general, how research is conducted, and as well as a lot of techniques that I'll definitely have to use when I'm a graduate student.